Our lab is mostly focused on renewable energy, and there are so many renewable energy sources, but we are mostly focused on solar. So we are trying to mimic what leaf does. What leaf does is absorb all the harmful gases, such as carbon dioxide, convert not so useful chemicals into useful chemicals, such as oxygen that we can use to breathe. We call that is photosynthesis. But what our lab is mostly doing is called as artificial photosynthesis. So we are trying to mimic what the leaves is doing. So we want to use only sunlight. We can change water that's really abundant in our earth into hydrogen. That's a very good fuels. The sun has a lot of energies. So like for example, with 80 hours of sun shine on our earth, that if we can collect it, all this energy, it can be used for our human beings for 1 year. So we just need to find a better way to store it. For right now, with photovoltaics, we can collect it, but it's changing to electricity. If we didn't use it, it's gone.
Solar panels capture sunlight and turn it into electricity. And so if a cloud goes overhead or the sun sets like it tends to do at the end of the day, you run out of electricity. Whereas with what we're doing and using sunlight to form chemical bonds in the form of hydrogen gas, that hydrogen gas you can store kind of like methane or natural gas and burn it throughout the night as a clean energy source.
And it's not just like one scientist can solve the problem. It's like once we are at some stages that we know like we can do something, we need to push that to into a bigger scale. We need engineers and like economists. And then we need all the politics, that's the people to push that the current fossil fuel based politics to more renewable energy based politics. So we need a lot of different type of people in order to make things work.
Yeah, it's definitely a team effort.